Lieutenant Stan was not only a soldier, but he was really like a father. You left me with the 20 orphans, and you didn't tell me what to do with them. Now, this is not a statistic to me. These are four of my buddies. She called me the first time and said, "Dad, how would you like to go to Warsaw?" And my first answer was, "No, I don't think I'm very eager to go there. If it wasn't for Rita, I wouldn't be standing here. I would never have gone to Poland alone." When I left Warsaw, was all that things was falling apart, I said, "I hope I never put my foot on that street again."
My father lived about 200 yards from the Warsaw ghetto, a few square blocks of walls sheltering the remnants of the half million or more Jewish citizens of Poland's capital.
The fire brigade was standing there pouring water on a Christian building where the Jewish building was burning. Out of one of this balcony, I saw a Jewish woman with the flames. The dress was on fire, jumping out of the balcony, dropping on the courtyard behind it.
The time when I saw that woman jump, I was, I think I was embarrassed to be alive.
They believe that there is a time that we, with our own hands, will liberate the capital of Poland. Just as soldiers, you know, there were no army, of course, that was the underground army. Even kids, because so many kids participated in the Warsaw Uprising.
We're in the center of the big, big action. And unfortunately, we are on the receiving end. Germans had everything at their disposal, and we are running out of ammunition. Eventually, we end up with absolutely nothing except bayonets. By that time, we thought we were going to be in those ruins and just fight hand to hand with SS as they approach us. Everything was on fire. It was extremely difficult to find the original roadways. Debris were covering almost the entire area. And of course, we had shooting, machine guns, artillery a little further on. Luckily, we have no planes diving on us at that stage. But we knew that it was the end of the line, and we went to, just before we went to those sewers, we were convinced that the whole city was already leveled.
My father didn't talk about Warsaw Uprising for so many years because of the communists that manipulated with the history or deleted the part of the history of Poland. Your father kept silent for so many years for a different reason, right? He didn't return to the pain that he remembered from these 63 days in Warsaw.
And of course, we met officials, we met ministers without portfolios, met the president, and everybody seemed like there was words for me to come back. And renew the friendships that I made. Now, I don't know if I'm going to be back again, because the years are rolling by. So now, I would just make a very pompous move, and I'm going to quote Churchill, paraphrase him actually, and I would say that if I lived 100 years, coming to Warsaw was my final hour.